see, we're always coming from. No, no, it just ain't right, baby. My God, she wouldn't let him in. Now without a fight, I'm leaving Virginia behind me. She's so blinded to what makes me see. I'm leaving Virginia behind me. I'm not the kind of man, no. She wants me to be. I'm leaving Virginia behind me. Lord knows I'll never, never be.
For a second.
Okay.
We're standing. All right. Salute. I didn't know I did that.
Anyway, hope you guys are having fun tonight. Hope you can spread the word. And hope you become my friends on Facebook too. Did I tell you this is Zach over here? This guy owns. Well, I don't want to say he owns a distillery. I wish he did, because if I did, I'd have all kinds of product. But he's kind of close to it.
I assist.
You assist, that's right. An assistant is good, right? This is my good friend, Zach. Please give it up for him, would you? And this is Jonah back here, the quiet one. He doesn't have much to speak of most of the time. And any of you guys know me, I don't lie.
False.
That is a falsehood, right? That's right. Anyway, ever since I heard this song, man, I've always wanted to do it. So I think for this show, I wanted to learn it and do it, and I hope you like it, because I don't really see a lot of folks doing a lot of these songs, to be honest with you. And hopefully it's bringing back some good memories for you and bringing you back to a peaceful time, a place in your life where things might have been a little bit easier, right? At least they seemed like they were a little easier. I don't know if they were or not. But it's always a lot good to think that they were, right? Anyway.
Stuff and drink all that way. Made up my mind to make a mistake. Going to California with a Nikki in my mind. Someone told me there's a girl out there loving to rise and flowers in it. Wondering how tomorrow could ever follow today. Yeah. The mountains in the valleys try to tremble to shake the children of the sun again.
Watch out.
Meet you there with a pass rule stand.
those guitars cry and sing. I remember on the precincts of dawn, trying to find a woman who's never, never, never been gone. Standing on a hill on my mountain of dreams, telling myself it's not as hard as it seems. I did my best. I just love it anyway. Anyway, I'm gonna do a song for you. When I was on The Voice, I have to say, it was, there again, not to be redundant, but it was a great experience. But I came out to do my blind audition, and I seriously, in the back of my mind, I settled for the fact that nobody was going to turn around because it was getting so late into the song. And literally, there was only about, I think, 6 or 7 notes. I forgot the count. And all of a sudden, I was hoping for Adam. But Adam's team was really already filled. I know a lot of people don't know this stuff, but the team was already filled because, you know, first and foremost, you've got to go through 44,800 people. I know these figures. It's like, wow, that's astronomical, you know. Just to be able to get down to the top 100, and then the top 100 down to the top 48, and then those 48 down to the 36, right, and so on and so forth. You get, so it's pretty astronomical. But when I found out that Sammy Hagar was going to be, you know, the mentor, I was like ecstatic. You know, when the producers kept on asking me, well, Dan, if you had a choice, who would you like to pick? I said, Adam! You know, but unfortunately, it was like day 3 or something like that. One day would go by, second day, 3 day. And I know I looked pretty disheveled there, but they would let us know, you know, like 9 o'clock every night, we'd have to go to the meeting room at the hotel, and all of us would gather around, and they'd have this list of all the people who were going to go the next day, right? So each night that came by, it's like, oh, that wasn't me. Okay, so I'll go back to bed, you know. But finally, on the fourth night, you know, but prior to that, they say you have to pack up all your bags and get ready to go, because if you're not going to go, they directly, you know, send you right back to the hotel, and you're on a flight. It's that fast, really. You're in and out. And so it's pretty kind of crazy. So on the fourth night, they had 9 o'clock. We went there and they said, well, they haven't gone through the day's, you know, blinds yet. 10 o'clock, come on back. We came back at 10. Came back and they said, still haven't done it. It's 11 o'clock, come on back. 11 o'clock came, still haven't done it. They said midnight. So we got back about midnight. And they finally called my name. It's like, oh my gosh. Well, praise God, right? But the thing is, he had to get up at 3:30. It's like, oh my goodness. You know, I'm getting older here, I guess. I don't know. I'm just getting kind of late. So when they did finally have me on the show, and, Trelawney and my you know, mentors and everybody else were so gracious. I mean, they were so great, and they finally just gave me a hug and said, okay, Dan, you're going to go now in a few minutes. You know, I tell you, your heart, you talk about palpitations and all that stuff. You're sitting there on, you know, national television, and there's no room for mistakes. I mean, it's not like this where you can flounder and say you can get by with it. You know, you're going to go keep on repeating and say, oh, there it is right there, right? And it just doesn't go away. But it's really something, I tell you. Nothing scares me. I could drop my drawers right now and not feel anything about it. It wouldn't bother me. But to get on national TV, it's like, oh my gosh. That kind of freaks me out. But I was so emotional because I was tired, you know, and it was something. But when I turned around, I was holding back from crying so much. It was just something. And then Blake finally came up and he hugged me, and it's like, you know, he's hugging his belly button. That's for you. It's like, man, he's a tall fella. It's pretty incredible, actually. You know, he really is. I mean, there's pictures of me. I'm standing on the stage, at least a 2-foot stage, and I'm still up to his shoulders. I mean, he's just a massive guy, but a beautiful man, you know, regardless of what everybody says. The same thing about Miley. I got to tell you, you know, a lot of people saw her twerking and all this stuff and saying that she's this and that. Well, I did a lot of stupid stuff, too, when I was a boy. And I tell you, when I'm 21, 22, 22, you do a lot of crazy stuff. I'm sure we all did. But she was one of those loving, compassionate, empathetic individuals. I mean, she'd sit, you know, from here to there and make sure that she came over just to hug me, tell me that she loved me and wish me well and so forth, you know. So it was just a beautiful thing, and so I can say nothing but nice things about The Voice. So if you're not a fan of The Voice, that's okay, but if you are, it really is a great, great place to be. So yeah, thank you. I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for that anyway. But I do thank you guys so much. But anyway, here's something from The Voice. Forever could never be long enough for me to feel like I've had love enough with you. Forgive the world now, we won't let them see. No, there's one thing left to do. Now that the wind is lifted, and love has finally shifted my way. Say you will, baby. I've been a Bad Company fan for a long time. In fact, I work with I sing in a band called the Classic Rock All-Stars with Troy Lucetta from the group Tesla and Paul Warren from Rod Stewart and so forth. So it's always a privilege for me to get to do the Bad Company stuff. So we're going to do some Bad Company for you. Is that all right with you, some Bad Company? For those of you who are diehard Bad Company fans, you'll know this one. If you don't, I'll introduce you to it, okay? Something called Seagull. This was actually done by the Coasters first. It's a great song, but then Bad Company did it again, so I kind of like their version too, but I love the Coasters. You might know this one or remember it. If you know it, sing along with it. It's okay too.
Looky there, baby, looky there.
Shelton. What's your name? What's your name, baby? What's your name? Sipping on a little water here. Anyway, I'm so grateful you guys came out tonight.
Thank you.
Died in his bed, bottle of whiskey, sleeping. your tablets of Isaiah, yeah. Jonah's not passing by like I want to be. If you listen to the wind, you can still hear him playing. Don't you know? Still is. I'm so grateful. Keeping the rock rolling. That's been my slogan for a long time right now. Keep the rock rolling, right? Anyway, I got one more for you, as far as that goes. You probably saw some of this cut. I did a song with Mr. Sundance Head, who ended up winning the whole thing, so that was good. So I came in second place, I guess you might want to say, but I kind of doubt it. But anyway, it's all right, man. I'm just grateful to have done what I've done, so.
I think about love. Darling, don't be without you. And your love. And if I had those golden dreams of my yesterday, I feel.